Justice Department and the FBI.
The group of Republicans sending a letter to Attorney General Jeff Sessions questioning the agency's leadership decisions. So is a special counsel needed? Here to weigh in is Fox News judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano. Thank you for waking up early and coming to spend some time with us.
It's good to be with you. This was the subject of great dispute yesterday when President Trump tweeted that very negative, some would say mean-spirited, some would say typically Trumpian tweet about Jeff Sessions, the essence of which was, why is the inspector general investigating this? He can't indict. He can't charge. All he does is report. Why don't we have a real investigation with prosecutors and FBI agents? So nobody knows where this is going to go. Question, can the FBI investigate itself? Or do we need another special counsel, remembering that special counsels often expand their own authority and indict people for things that have nothing to do with the original mission with which they were charged?
Do you think it's needed?
I think a serious investigation is needed. I actually agree with the president on this. I don't think I would have expressed it the way he did towards Attorney General Sessions, who was a friend of mine. But I do believe that the whole FISA system is wrong and has been abused. And what we have seen, thanks to Congressman Nunes and the House Intelligence Committee, is just the tip of the iceberg.
If Sessions were to investigate this themselves, the FBI, the DOJ investigates itself, that would probably bring a big cloud over whatever the results are, right? I mean, that's got to be what he's thinking.
It would certainly, Rob, bring a cloud if they're exonerated. But if somebody is indicted or otherwise punished for causing the government, the power of the government, to be used to investigate the president and Mrs. Clinton's enemies, now the president of the United States, the Trump campaign, I think the public would see that the right thing was being done. Jeff Sessions would insulate himself personally from this if he were to designate another special counsel like Bob Mueller. He could even ask Bob Mueller to expand his authority, since he already has a team independent of the Justice Department already working there.
How do you feel Jeff Sessions is doing?
I think he is qualified for the job by temperament, by experience, and by education. But I think he's giving the impression that he is aloof and not in charge, and I wish he didn't give that impression. I understand the president's frustration. If I were the president, I would pick up the phone and talk to him. I wouldn't do it by tweets, but I'm not Donald Trump. He has his own style, and that resonates with his base. But I wish Jeff Sessions were more hands-on.
Yeah. Judge, we got to get to this. Everybody's talking about guns right now.
Yes.
You've got an op-ed out today. We want to let you talk about it a little.
I want to remind people that the right to keep and bear arms was put in the Constitution, not to protect the right to shoot deer, but to protect the right to stay alive, to shoot back at bad guys, at crazy people, or even at the government if it were taken over by tyrants.
And you can see part of it up on the screen there. I was reading it this morning, and something that kind of struck me is where you say, I realize it's nearly impossible to engage rationally with tears and pain, which is why we need to take a step back from this tragedy, and you're talking about what happened in Florida. But, I mean, how do you do that when you have these high school-aged kids demanding change and the conversation that we've never had to this extent is happening?
Here's the change that I would bring about. Every one of these killings, the nightclub in Orlando, the government offices in San Bernardino, Newtown, Parkland, Columbine, they all occurred in gun-free zones. These are killing zones. These are the most dangerous places on earth. The government should not establish places like this because it makes us vulnerable to our enemies, and the bad people and the crazy people know that. That's a change government can make. When I heard the president say yesterday, confiscate first and due process later, that is wrong. And as much as I love and respect him, I believe that that's an emotional response to the tears and the pain. It's not a rational conclusion.
That's what I was just in a few seconds. I was going to ask you that the president's moved pretty far left here on the gun issue in the last couple of days, or so it would seem.
He has. And again, I think it's because of the emotion, which is why I said we need to take a step back. And remember, the highest right is the right to life. And the right to life means we have the right to self-defense. And the right to self-defense means we have the right to use the most advanced technological means to protect ourselves. Okay. That's not me. That's the Supreme Court of the United States, an opinion written by Justice Scalia in 2008.
Judge, thank you for joining us this
morning. What a pleasure, guys.
Thank you so much.